Today, I want to share a project with you that I've been working on over the last years. This project is about having positive impact on people and planet by supporting this phone for more than 5 years. Coming from a software engineering background, I was experimenting with Fairphone devices since Fairphone 1 came out 7 years ago. It was very exciting for me, being able to open up the device and discover what's inside. When Fairphone started building up a software team to work on the Fairphone 2, I took the opportunity, moved to Amsterdam, and joined Fairphone on their mission to create fairer electronics. The electronics industry is well known for two things: its quick innovation cycles with new exciting technologies every year, and its huge negative impact on society and environment. 1.4 billion phones are sold every year. Every phone is only kept for 2 to 3 years on average in Europe. And only 50% of phones are reused or recycled. 50 million tons of e-waste are produced every year, and 70% of it is illegally disposed in developing countries, harming nature and people around it. This make-use-dispose attitude affects the entire industry and every link in the supply chain. At Fairphone, we are working in 4 impact areas: fair mining, worker welfare, reuse and recycle, and also longevity. Because the longer you use your phone, the less e-waste you produce. Also, most of the CO2 emissions are generated during production, not usage of a phone. That means, overall, the longer you use your phone, the lower the impact on the environment. We have 2 approaches for realizing longevity: modularity and long-lasting software support. Let me start with modularity. This is a camera module of the Fairphone 2. In the Fairphone 2, you have 6 modules like this. So if you accidentally drop the phone and the screen breaks, you can easily replace it. If the battery wears out, you can get a new one. For the camera, we even created an upgraded module, because we knew that people would want to take great pictures even when their phone gets older. In retrospect, we've faced many challenges with the modularity. How long would each of those modules last? How many modules do we need to produce for the full life cycle of the phone? How can we estimate this in advance? We learned a lot on this on Fairphone 2, also for our future products. Our second approach is long-lasting software support. And today, we officially release Android 9 to the Fairphone 2. This marks 5 years of continued support. But what does it mean? Did you ever wonder why you need to install software updates all the time? Let me explain. We need software updates for 3 main reasons: to keep even newer apps running well, for security, and performance and stability. Without security updates, your personal data would be at risk. Think of all your personal memories on your phone, or even your bank details. Also, on the Fairphone 2, we invested a lot in keeping also newer apps running well while the hardware is getting older. On the Fairphone 2, we have a Qualcomm Snapdragon 801 chipset. Every other phone on the market with a similar chipset reached end of life years ago. And today, Fairphone 2 is the only phone on the market with a similar chipset that receives an official upgrade to Android 9. The road to Android 9 has been a challenging one. To understand this, let's have a look where Android is coming from. Android is released by Google through AOSP, the Android Open Source Project. Chipset vendors such as Qualcomm take the code from AOSP and modify it further to make it run on their chipsets. Then we take the code from the chipset vendors and modify it so that it runs on our specific phones. For example, on the Fairphone 2, we made sure that Android works well together with our specific camera modules. Also, we put the Google apps on the phone so that you can install all your apps through the Google Play Store. At the end of the process, we get approval from Google. For the Google approval, we have to go through some 100,000 tests. And this is really the biggest challenge for us, because if one single test does not pass for us, we're really stuck on the project. In case of the Fairphone 2, Qualcomm stopped supporting the chipset already after Android 6. That made the upgrade to Android 7 already way more difficult than, for example, the upgrade to Android 6. We overcame this difficulty by working together with Lineage. Lineage is an open source operating system based on Android. Because Lineage and our own system are both open source, we could share a lot of source code and knowledge with each other. For Android 9, once again, we worked together with Lineage and without Qualcomm support, because Android 6 was the last Qualcomm-supported Android version. The jump to Android 9 is way bigger, though, than compared to Android 7. At the same time, the Google approval process is getting more and more complex. For Android 9 on Fairphone 2, we had to run 480,000 tests to get the approval and pass all of them. Eventually, we found solutions for all of the remaining issues. And this was the moment where we knew we could make it to an official Android 9 for the Fairphone 2. The reason why we did this project, even though it was difficult, is because we want to have a positive impact with our phones. We did it, and we are proud to show the industry that even with our small team, it's possible to support your phones longer. There's one thing I want you to remember. If you need a new phone, also check what your favorite manufacturer is doing on software. Because software too is crucial in making smartphones more sustainable.